one of the main reasons is financial benefit. When they did their cost analysis and a case study and had reviewed some of the case studies that we've already done with other customers, they could see that if they invested X amount, they'd have it paid back typically within about 4 to 5 years. And as the system that they've chosen is of high caliber, they're confident that they're going to get 20 plus years service life out of it. So this site can take on average about 600 kilowatts a day of power. So we put a system in that we think is going to at least take away 2/3 to up to 75%, depending on the time of year and the weather, of their energy bills. Here is bananas, but they also have got quite a number of acres under management in regards to avocados. The potential energy saving between their three sites that we're looking at is between $90 and $115,000 a year. And that depends on the current tariffs and the weather and how much they utilise their self-consumption. But they were very happy with that, and when they run the figures on it, they went for it. I think because of the higher cost of the embedded ground mount system, I think the average, including the rooftop solar, which has a payback of around about 4.4 years, and the ground mounts have an average of about 6.5 years, I would say there'd be a mean average of about 5.25 years across the three sites with 300 kilowatts. But they have a couple of smaller embedded pumps, and of those for irrigating, one's a 37 kilowatt pump, the other one's a 45 kilowatt pump and a 55 kilowatt pump. But because they're also a VSD, variable speed drive, the actual drawing would be only about 30 to 35 kilowatts. Because not every day they need to irrigate, so they wanted to feed in as well. So that site has got feed in. So we put 30 kilowatts inverter with 40 kilowatt panels on ground mounts for those two sites. Just talking about feed in, we managed to create or redistribute another electricity count on the main packing shed, and we redistributed the power across the packing shed there. And so they're getting a feed-in tariff of 230 kilowatt inverters and 40 kilowatt panels in each, so 80 kilowatts. So even when they're not in production, they're getting a feed-in as we speak up in the main farm. And that was something that they were very keen for.